Okay, all of our participants have joined us, so let's get started. That's Digital Storytelling Workshop organized by American Center Tashkent. We say welcome back to those who have been with us from the beginning of this workshop, and welcome to those who are new here. So this month, we are discussing the issues of children, and we are mostly concentrating on digital stories created by children. So the name of this month's workshop is Children of the Planet Earth, and let's get started. So before we start today's workshop, I would like to quickly summarize the points we made in the previous workshop. In the previous workshop, we have mostly discussed the issues children are facing throughout the world and how can digital stories address these issues. So now, when we concentrate on the process of creating digital stories by children, the first question arises is, should it therefore follow out that we should encourage children away from screens wherever possible? So nowadays, children have more communication with screens than in-person communication. So is it necessary or is it even possible to encourage children away from the screens in today's world? Well, the answer largely depends on your views as a parent, as a teacher. But regarding digital storytelling, I would say no. We should really give children some screen time to create digital stories. And if you follow up with us, I will tell you the reasons why I think so. Well, digital stories, it's just stories, and it offers many ways to deliver stories and share stories with each other. So developmentally, digital storytelling offers huge opportunities, and children find great fun and find it extremely engaging. This is the very first reason why digital storytelling should become a curriculum must do in teaching children. Now, there are some points that digital storytelling has advantages for kids' use. First of all, it has something to do with children's confidence. So digital storytelling can be a great way to build a child's confidence. For example, if a child is too shy to perform in public, or recording a performance on a mobile phone and playing it back for friends can be a solution. It can be much less daunting to, as a start. Then creating something as a team or alone is equally a wonderful way to support self-esteem development. As children discover, they really can come up with and deliver their own stories. Last but not least, the breadth of digital options means that children aren't restricted by their ability to draw, write, or act, as there are so many tools available to help them. That's why it's very important that children get engaged in digital storytelling. Another reason is digital storytelling boosts creativity. Being creative is incredibly rewarding at any age and so important to child's development. It helps to build invaluable life skills from problem solving to self-expression and etc. Digital stories enable children to explore their personality, develop confidence, and practice all sorts of skills, often touching on social, emotional, cognitive, physical, and language along the way. Story creation in any form is creative, empowering for the imagination, and digital storytelling opens up a huge range of additional creative avenues. That's why digital storytelling is a great way to boost the creativity of children. As parents or as teachers, you can really encourage classroom use of different tools in order to give your kids chance to be creative. Digital stories can be a really bridge to adult life. It can prepare children to adult life. So many roles in society use skills developed through digital storytelling. There are, of course, obvious roles like film directors, actors, actresses, producers, photographers, authors, journalists, bloggers. So today's world has offered many professions that has to do with digital storytelling. So sometime in future, your students will need these skills. And if you start practicing the skills early on, they will have a better skill in doing this kind of jobs. So graphic design, sales, marketing, everything requires digital storytelling today. In reality, the skills are required to put together a good story and present it in any way that is really fun way, first of all, and also very effective. That's why it can prepare your students to adult life. As we are mostly English teachers, it has an advantage regarding language and literacy. Digital storytelling in some forms could be criticized for taking children away from writing and language development, but this does not have to be the case. There are many tools available for children that offers excessive writing practice for children. We would encourage digital storytelling to retain the written element and look for other opportunities to extend writing, spelling, language skills through digital storytelling. Well, today I'm going to mostly discuss about the platform called Night Zookeeper. It's a platform for creating digital stories by children, and I will show you how it works, what is it like, and using this kind of platforms, you can help to inspire creativity and challenge the writer with missions, requirements to use particular words in the narrative, and etc. So first of all, it can be a really good practice of language skills, literacy skills. It can enhance their digital literacy skills, and it's a fun way of getting children involved into self-expression. So with one word, children should have some screen time to tell digital stories. So basically, it can be somewhat scary to start digital storytelling with kids, especially if they are primary school kids, if they are very young. So how should we start? What are the practical guidance that we can offer them? First of all, start small. Get your child to read or perform their favorite book and then ask them to record it and practice so that they will feel okay under recordings. Also, photo stories is another way of practicing digital storytelling skills. So you can give your students or child a camera and challenge them to take pictures and put them into stories. Or you can turn it into a game of play together. So one person starts the story, another person continues, and etc. And there are some stop animations available. These are tools that offers great opportunities for digital storytelling. We will discuss them further now. Okay, there are some apps or programs that helps your young learners or kids to enhance their digital storytelling skills. I will give some examples of this storytelling apps. First of all, there are many of them available now for free or for premium use, but there are many of them available. Some of them are Mr. Glue, Sidling Comic Studios, The Traditional Storyteller, Easy Studio, Scratch Junior, and etc. And today we will be concentrating on Night Zookeeper app, which is very interesting and engaging to be used by children. So stay with us and we will be now switching on to the Night Zookeeper. Okay, so to start with, you should look into nightzookeeper.com. The address is right here. So this kind of window pops up. That's Night Zookeeper's homepage. As you can see, it's very interesting and catchy for children. First of all, in order to start, you have to have an account on this website. So you can register now. We'll just go through all these processes together. So you can register as a child, as a teacher, as a parent. If you are getting your children into work, you can register your students, or you can get an account as a teacher. If you're a parent practicing it with your own kids, then you can choose parent accounts. So after you register, the window opens up and it gives you many, many, let's say, tools and tutorials to start with. So what is Night Zookeeper and how does it look like? So what is it like working on Night Zookeeper? Okay, first of all, to get started on nightzookeeper.com, you are going to go through the parent guide, and there is teacher guide as well. As you read carefully this guide, it will give answers to all the questions that you have regarding this application. So first of all, how to get your children started? You will be visiting nightzookeeper.com. The address is right here, and I will be sending it to your chat. And then you will click child login button. So it's right here, that's child login button. Then next we'll be clicking registering, and then you will choose a username. It can be a fun way of creating a username. It can be the first step of your children to creativity. So after that, they can choose their own password, and then they will have an account. So here, you will enter your username, then you can sign in with your Google account as well. After that, you will choose an easy password to be remembered by children. If you are doing it with your small children, or if you are doing it with your students who are primary class kids, I really recommend you to let them choose usernames and passwords. So that's one of the digital skills that is required nowadays. So after you make sure that your children have chosen a password and remembered that, you can get started with the tutorial. So children will get to create their own unique Night Zookeeper avatar. It means that they will have a profile picture on this website, and this profile picture will be displayed next to all pieces of writing they produce. It can be edited later as well. So for example, your kids can choose this avatar, change its colors, and etc. So it will be a fun way of starting. Once completed, children will then arrive at the main menu where they can launch all the different activities on nightzookeeper.com. First of all, here, they will be clicking on your zoo button. It's right here. So after they start that, so they will be challenged to create their first magical animal to live in the night zoo. They will answer to the questions about it, give it a name, write the first animal report, and etc. This can be an example. So as you can see here, there are names and there are avatars available. They can talk among themselves if you are working in groups. After that, they will be given goals to try and achieve in their writing. So this is a really important part because it has lots of learning value. Here as a teacher, via your teacher account, you can assist them in writing process by giving them certain number of words, adjectives, verbs, paragraphs, etc. This website automatically assesses the writing to determine if children can achieve these goals. So if website gives this kind of instructions in writing, for example, use two verbs in your writing, use three adjectives in your writing, use the transition word once when linking your ideas, it will automatically check up if your students are able to follow this. So it will really take your students' writing skills to the next level. Next, well, you will be describing your animal here on the writing page. As you can see, writing page has most of the Microsoft Word options, like writing in bold, underlining, choosing shifts, and etc. So, well, when children achieve their goals, they get orbs. That's also a fun way of encouraging them to continue writing. And how can children use orbs? Orbs are points that children can use in Night Zoo to collect other animals or to customize their animals. Once you get through this, you will get used to this. And there are some special lessons and comments from night zookeeper teacher. So you can assist them as a teacher yourself via your teacher account. And also there is a teacher assistance that will give them commands, that will send them their commands as a messages. It's also a fun way of communicating between teachers and students. Okay, so after they have watched the tutorial, they will start writing process. So, okay, so here is their first page, and this is the missing word challenge. What they are going to do is they are going to put these words together. So they will be able to connect this sentence, and then that would be their first sentence to start with. So in the beginning, Night Zookeeper gives them ideas, words, and jumbled up sentences so that children will not have difficulty in starting from scratch. So first of all, they will build confidence in writing via given templates. After that, they can write their own story, which is also a great way to start writing. Well, there is a reading comprehension challenge available on this website. So as you can see, here's a reading comprehension. They will read it after they can reflect on that. There is a word game available. So again, they will be putting the words in order to make up a sentence. That's a really good way of practicing English grammar. And there are awards for getting things done quickly and perfectly. So they will be collecting awards like in a pen shape, in a book shape, which is really encouraging for future writers. Okay, and there is a challenge or a competition called Writing League on this website. For extra motivation, students can check to writing leagues to see how their team are doing. If you are registering teams, for example, you have divided your students into teams and you have registered each team separately, it can be a great way of observing how teams are doing. So here you can see the usernames of all your students, their countries and their points, their overall points, and etc. So basically everything is done here, and it's the great way of getting started writing. So it will be probably the very first digital story they will create. And when starting with this website, you can advise this website to children as early as 6 years old. I'm sure that your primary school students can keep up with this. Everything is organized and there are many tutorials available. Just go get started on this website. This is going to be our task for today's workshop. So today we will be working on this website. Now we will all get registered on this nightzookeeper.com. We will discuss our processes, and as teachers, we will try to see what is it like. We are going to experience it ourselves. So today, try to create your first own digital story using the tutorials available on this website. And next time, we'll be taking this to the next level, which means that we will be asking our students or children to get involved in the practice. And at the end of this month, we will be sharing a children's story created by children and somehow addressing the issues children are facing in today's world, like lack of education and etc. So you can give hints, you can guide your students, you can give them ideas to start with. And I really recommend you to use this website as a basic tool to create digital stories, because it's fun, it's engaging, it's easy to follow, and it really concentrates on writing narrative. So that's basically it for the first part. Now, after a short break, we will start working on the nightzookeeper.com. If you have questions during the break time, you can email your questions or you can write your questions into the chat. I will see you shortly.